No money spent. You guys are loving it. It's fun to grind the team out. But let's forget all about that. Let's talk about all money spent. Let's talk about the God Squad. I think I have the best 88 of all time. We'll get into the team. But if you want to watch this team play live, twitch.tv/dub. That link is below. Any offense, defense, anything you see here, maddenturf.com. That link is also below. The Seattle Seahawks offensive playbook is available now. Will be updated this week. I found tons of new plays that I like to run that I want to update with this ebook this week, man. The defensive ebook is in the works too. I wanted to wait till I got a little more comfortable on defense, give you guys some real gems. So if you guys need any help right there, maddenturf.com. That link is below. But let's get into this game. Like I said, all money spent, no more budget players, no, not for this video, but we're going to talk about what my team looks like now, the real team. And I told you, I think this is the greatest 88 overall of all time. I'll show you guys what I did. I really nerded out mutt wise. I have Lamar Jackson, Bo Jackson, the Jackson backfield, have Juli Manduli, the limited. We have Tyreek Hill. We have the new Brandon Cooks, limited, who is the fastest receiver in the game at 95 speed. Bakhtiari, Joe Thuney, Travis Frederick, Jarre Evans, Mitchell Schwartz. You see, I have Schwartz and Thuney starting on the offensive line, which are Michael Finley. The reason I have Schwartz and Thuney is because I actually have 25 Patriots and 25 Chiefs. This is pretty much unheard of to have two themed teams like this and also still keep my Lamar Jacksons, my Julio Jones, my Bo Jacksons, Jermichael Finley, all the great players I still have, but 25 Chiefs, 25 Patriots. What does that mean? Tyreek Hill is 94 speed and Brandon Cooks is 95 speed, the fastest wide receiver core you could possibly have right now. So I'm feeling really good about that. But I have to start Mitchell Schwartz at tackle. I start Thuney at guard. The abilities I use, identifier on Travis Frederick. I like seeing where the user is, what adjustments they make, what players they touch. If I catch them on a D-line, I want to snap, get them out of there, get an easy free play. Mitchell Schwartz, edge protector. David Bakhtiari, edge protector. I have post up on Jarre Evans. Kind of flirting with the 1 AP, maybe double teams for these three-man rushes will help me a lot. Lamar Jackson, I've talked about this before, the abilities I have on Lamar Jackson. Escape artist and second wind. Second wind helps him keep his stamina, man. Escape artist, the one thing I noticed about it is you will lose your stamina a lot faster. So I got that second wind ability on him. You guys might overlook it, but it really helps for your quarterback if you're running around, making plays, running read options, running quarterback runs. You want to keep your quarterback fresh because once he gets tired, man, he feels really slow. Defense. This is where we make our bones. I have the new Jamal Adams. Don't have him in this gameplay, but I will have him for weekend league. So make sure you guys tune in for that. We have Byron Jones at corner. We have Asante Samuel. We have Gilly Lock, Stephon Gilmore, that 992 overall, chemmed up with that 25 Patriots. That's where it helps me. Gives Gilmore and Asante Samuel more speed. They're faster. Tyrann Mathieu chemmed up with that Chiefs chem. He's a dog in the game. I never liked 5'9 players. Tyrann Mathieu shows out. Devin McCourty, Jason McCourty, these guys are just there for Patriots chems. Chandler Jones, Patriot chem. I have Seymour, Elvis Dumervil, Adalis Thomas. Those are the main guys I use. Pretty much everybody else here I don't use, but they're there for chems. Seau, Hightower, Bobby Bell, Sam Mills, obviously. And we see Chris Jones down here, D Ford, Frank Clark. All the Chiefs and Patriots I can get and fit on a team. Of course, we have Isaiah Simmons, the best user in the game. Let me show you where I hide some players, too, is what you can do. Go to Specialist. We're going to hide some players. Miles Garrett, defensive tackle, Cleveland Browns. I have him. Really athletic. Really good pass rush if you guys want him. I don't think he's super expensive, and he also has chems built in. So if you guys don't want to waste training, his superstar card has chems built in, which is awesome about it. Slot corner, where I hide two goons. Rod Woodson, the new Denzel Ward. Now, like I said, I don't have Denzel Ward for this gameplay, but this weekend league, I will have him and show you guys. He has 95 speed. Now, honestly, chems on defense, I'm all over the place. I wish I could tell you guys I know exactly what works. I'm still trying a bunch of them. If you guys, what chems you guys use, let me know below in the comments, man. I need all suggestions because I will try it all, trying to find the OP chems on defense. So let's get into this gameplay, see if my defense could hold up with whatever chems I used. All right, we see my man coming out in the trips tight end. That's one of the most popular formations in the game this year. And the number one thing defending this, you really need to stop inside zone. That's why I've gone to more of a four down line look as we get a big hit on the quarterback early. I think four down line does a great job of being able to shoot gaps, stop that run in the backfield with your Adrian Wilsons and your Isaiah Simmons, man. And we're going to play a lot of man coverage just because, man, zone is so easy to attack out of this trips tight end. So I'm trying a little bit of man coverage, mixing in some zones here and there, playing defense. One thing about this year, I think you have to play defense and you can't just call a defense as we get a huge acrobat interception from Asante Samuel. Now, I told you guys, I don't really know about abilities. I know one that really works. So I try to go up top for the touchdown to Cooks. I get hit. And Adrian Wilson comes up with the interception. Man, I had the touchdown, but I definitely got hit. But like I said, I don't really know the perfect defensive abilities, but I will tell you, Acrobat works, man. So if you want those diving interceptions, you want to be able to knock the ball out, make sure you equip Acrobat on some of your best DBs. And we got Lamar Jackson under a lot of pressure right now. We have Adalys Thomas. We have Doomerville, Myles Garrett, and Richard Seymour in that line. So they're getting after. I like to send five people most of the time, five or six right there. We get a huge sack from Rod Woodson sending off the edge right there. Second and 21 for him. Steps up in the pocket this time. Takes off with Lamar Jackson. Picks up over 15 yards. That's the lethal weapon Lamar Jackson provides. Next play, he's going to roll out. Send the spy at him. Doesn't have anywhere to go with the ball. Throws the ball away. We get to a fourth and five early. We're going to drop back and he hits the slant. I had a zone over there. Just didn't play it aggressive enough. Gave up the fourth down there. Next play, we're going to drop back. I have the deep post under guard. I bait him a little bit. He gets hit while throwing and Adrian Wilson comes up with a huge interception. Got to send that pressure, man. You got to rely on your pressure. I pretty much was burnt by that guy, but the pressure got home, hit him. Came up with a huge pick to turn the ball over. So we're sloppy early with a couple turnovers, but we're going to get things together right now on the offensive side of the ball. As we attack the cover two, rolled out here, Julio Jones is my slot receiver. Has that slot apprentice. I need that in the slot for the bunch to work. Read option inside the 5 yard line. Lamar Jackson. Next play, we're going to go with Bo. Bo knows end zone touchdown. Take the early 7-0 lead, man. When you get two stops early in the game, man, you have to take advantage. Go up. We go up 7-0. So we're feeling good about that. Got to play defense. No big plays in his trips. Can't give up big post routes or big crossing routes. That's the key, man. Make them take the underneath checkdowns as he steps up right here. There it is, throwing the ball to Bo Jackson. We're closing into the end of the first half, so just got to try to keep him out of the end zone here. Next play, I'm stuck on Richard Seymour. He's able to hit the crossing route to Jerry Rice. Got me caught on the fat D lineman. The fat D lineman is not going to run down there with Seymour. Then the next play hits the post route. So just when I told you, stop the crossing route in the post, he's able to hit both to get a touchdown and tie the game up. 1:16 left in the half. You guys know I can make something shake right here. 1:16, three timeouts, no big deal. Everything is still an option in the playbook. Screens, runs, draws, everything. But we'll drop back the first play. We're going to hit the drag route to JerMichael Finley. Get out of bounds. Even though I have three timeouts, you still got to, you know, preface getting out of bounds. That's really important because you can save those. But he needs to save his defense as we go up top to Brandon Cooks. Baja. Touchdown. Big bomb. 95 speed on that Brandon Cooks because of that Patriots chem and the 40-40 sprinter. Just absolute firepower between Tyreek Hill and Brandon Cooks. The fastest wide receiver core in the game right now. That's why I told you guys, I think I have the best 88 overall of all time with this much speed, but we got to hold him out of some points here. Send the dogs at him right there. Doomerville coming off the edge, getting the sack right there. Second and 15. He's out of timeouts, 20 seconds left, but he hits this crossing route to get close to field goal range. Now, what I do here is I don't rush anybody. Well, not this play, but this is a situation where he runs out of time, runs away, and he throws the ball away. Now, he has 10 seconds, has to get out of bounds. I don't rush anybody right here because I want him to waste his time. I know he wants to get rid of the ball fast. I give him nowhere to go with the ball, and he throws it away. That makes this play the last play of the half. I'm going to play all-out coverage, drop everybody back deep, and he's going to have nowhere to go with the football. So just utilizing the time right there, making sure I didn't give up a field goal, and making sure I didn't give up the sidelines allowed me to keep him from scoring right there. Just a little strategic thing you guys should mix into your game, man. When they're up against it with time, they want to get rid of the ball quick, so use that to your advantage. Get the ball starting second half. I had that post again, but he ran with it, so I dumped it underneath the Tyreek Hill. Another good option. Right here, he blows up that read option with Lamar Jackson. that will come back to play later in the game as we get a sack off the edge and we get a big third and 20. We're going to drop back, have the time, go for the C route over here, and he swats it away with Dre Bly. Huge play defensively. I'm going to punt the ball. Fourth and 20, you don't want to go for any of these. In this game with the zone drops, really tough to get. So we're going to play, punt the ball, play defense. And as we get here, up 7 points. It's always good being up 7 points because at the end of the day, the worst case scenario is he ties the game up. You'll never be losing. So just still mixing up some people, still switching man and zone, sometimes putting a couple man defenders in zone and vice versa. Really try to confuse your opponent. When you play good passers, as we had a little crossing route open, but we got a lot of pressure there. When you play good passers, you never want to give them the same look twice. Once again, we hit the quarterback and Adrian Wilson get there. Ooh. That new Jamal Adams might get there. We'll find out on Weekend League this weekend how good he is. Third and 10, he goes to a screen and Bo Jackson almost picks it up. We're going to have a fourth down here. He's going to snap the ball. I'm played underneath and he hits this post route. Adrian Wilson right there again. Does Jamal Adams make that play? I will find out. We'll see if it's worth it for this $1 million limited card. Dropped right there, Adrian Wilson. Does Jamal Adams make that play? Who knows? Do they make Adrian Wilson weak now because the new Jamal Adams is out as he throws underneath to Tyreek Hill, picking up a bunch of yards. He's inside the red zone here. Nowhere for him to go here on this first and 10 play. Going to just delay. I need my guys to get home. He has all day right now. But finally, someone gets home. I'll send a spy. Throws the ball away, man. We get to a second and 10. Going to snap the ball here. Roll out to the right. And Finley just cooks. I'll tell you, man, that JerMichael Finley is probably the most unguardable player in the game. Now, I'll tell you, tight ends have pretty much been unguardable in the history of Madden. You get a good tight end, he will eat on linebackers, on DBs, on safeties, anything. But it, even more so, this JerMichael Finley card. As he sends the dogs, all right, go up top to Brandon, or that's Tyreek Hill. Maybe if it was Brandon Cooks with that one more point of speed, we would have got by Byron Jones right there. Next play, he only rushes two. I have all day. And my linemen don't pick up that spy, and we get a long yardage right now. Third and 16. We're going to drop back. He sends the crib, but leaves my man Tyreek Hill wide open on the fade. Baja. Big touchdown, man. Just a blown coverage right there. Got to take advantage of it. Got to find it, man. Third and 16, I probably would have played a little more passive after getting two big plays on first and second down defensively. But he gives up that touchdown. 2 minutes, 32 seconds. I'm up by 7 again. Feel good. It's always, like I said, the lead always feels good in any sport game, in any sport. But right now he hits Finley underneath. I sent the dogs there. Did not get home. He's able to find JerMichael Finley on the bailout there. Right, I need an interception right there. It was that Adrian Wilson again. I think it was Byron Jones, 24. The one thing about Mutt, man, sometimes you have four 24s on the field. Dre Bly making a play on Jerry Rice underneath. Once again, there's man coverage. He sends everybody out. That's the problem with man coverage. All your DB's backs are to the quarterback, and he picks up a huge gain of 22 yards on the scramble. Throws it underneath to Bo Jackson again. Gets 10 yards on the screen. Boy, screens are really, really tough this year. It's first and 10. He's going to drop back, hit the in route to Finley again, and get into the end zone. Huge drive right there. Tie game. 1:16 left. Three timeouts. I have done more with less. Easy. This is just easy. Like I told you, everything in the playbook is open. He rushes three, first down. We're going to hit the in route to Julio Jones. Hold that Y button to come back to the ball to make the play that Julio Jones made right there. Next play, we're going to throw this post route. Brandon Cooks caught in traffic, hit right there. There it is. Next play, read option. I know he's going to click on like he did in the first half, so I just gave the ball to the running back, and Bo Jackson takes it to the crib, but not so fast as I fall down inside the five. We're going to waste all the time, make him waste all his timeouts. Instead of scoring a touchdown, we're going to go ahead and milk it out and kick the last second field goal. He used his timeouts, won't be able to ice the kicker with Moran Anderson. This is an easy GG's in the comments section below, man. Hope you guys enjoyed that game. I know you guys are loving No Money Spent, but it's always good to get back in that Ferrari. After driving, you know, the 89 Buick, when you hop back in the Ferrari, it just feels a little bit more powerful, man. If you like the video, please hit the like button. Feel free to subscribe. We're going to keep pushing.